Namaste everyone, I am your co-host Shavani ma'am. Welcome to your favorite learning channel. The topic for today's video is Cattle Farming Part 3. So, earlier we have covered the two parts under cattle farming, and in our previous video, that is the Part 2 of cattle farming, we had discussed about the various crossbreeding techniques used in cattle farming, as well as we had discussed about the difference between the milch and draught varieties of cattle. Okay, so today in this part 3 section of cattle farming, we would be discussing about the food requirements of cattle as well as the different diseases that occur in cattle. Okay, so first we would begin with the feed of cattle. Okay, so the feed of cattle will be the first topic of discussion in this video. Okay, so the cattle require proper feeding, and the feeding requirement depends on the functions of life. So feeding requirement of dairy animal can be classified into two types. The feeding requirement, and this requirement is of dairy animals, can be classified into how many types? They can be classified into two types, and we will see what are these two types. So first is the maintenance requirement. And the second is the milk producing requirement. Okay, so in maintenance requirement, the animals require food to perform all the basic functions of life. So such food is required by the animal so that they can perform all the basic activities or basic functions of life. And the second type of requirement is the milk producing requirement, that is, it includes the type of food that is required during the lactation period. Alright, so now there are two types of food substances, or the feed we can say. So the animal feed is classified into two types of substances. Okay, and we will be seeing what are the two types of feed. Okay, so the component of animal feed, there are two types of substances. We can say that the animal feed is classified into how many types? Two types of substances. Okay, and the animal feeding directly affects the quality of milk yield. So what are these two types of substances of animal feed? We will be looking at them. One is the concentrates. Okay, so what are these concentrates? So it is a mixture of substances. Substances which are rich in one or more nutrients, and these nutrients are fats, proteins, carbohydrates, then minerals and vitamins. So these concentrates are actually a mixture of substances that are rich in one or more nutrients, like all these nutrients. Okay. So it has low content of fiber but has very high content of protein and other nutrients. So it also includes, so what does it include? It also includes, the concentrates can include oil seeds, it can include barley, oats, jowar, gram, bajra, etc., and other byproducts like, and other byproducts may also be present. Other byproducts like the gram husk, rice bran, etc. Alright, so this is about the concentrates. And the next substance of the animal feed is the roughage. Okay, so it largely contains fibers. So what does it contain largely? It largely contain fibers. Okay, it largely contains fibers, and these fibers can be green fodder, then silage, hay, also legumes, so legumes like cowpea, barseem, etc., these can be included in this roughage. Okay, so thus a balanced diet would have all the essential nutrients in correct proportion. This should be given to dairy cattle. Okay, so what is the general content of dairy cattle feed? That is the general content of the dairy cattle feed includes things like, we would see here, it includes green fodder and dry grasses, that is the roughage part. Okay, and this is about 15 to 20 kg. Okay, next, it also contains the grain mixture. So this grain mixture is actually the, it is actually the concentrate part. So these are the concentrates, and this would be between 4 to 5 kg. And in addition, there will also be water in their diet, which would be around 30 to 35 liters. Okay, so apart from the above content, the dairy cattle feed also contains additive feed such as antibiotics, minerals, hormones, etc. So, apart from this, there would also be additive feed. And what would additive feed include? It includes antibiotics, it includes hormones, etc. These would also be present. so as to facilitate the growth of animals and to obtain good yield of milk, and these will also help in protecting the animals or the cattle from diseases. Alright, so this is about the feed of cattle. Now moving forward, we will be discussing about the diseases of cattle and buffalo. So we would say the diseases of cattle and buffaloes. Alright, so let's see what are the different diseases that occur in these cattle and buffalo. So there are various diseases that adversely affect the production of milk and cause mortality of sick animals. Okay, so first we would begin with, so these diseases can be infectious. So the infectious diseases are those that are contagious diseases, which are caused by bacteria, viruses, parasites, fungi, etc., and these can spread by contact from one animal to the another. Okay, so these diseases can be infectious, that is they can spread among the group. If one cattle comes in contact, one cattle that is infected comes in contact with the other one. Okay, so first we will be talking about the parasitic diseases. The parasitic diseases. Okay, so there are two types of parasites, namely external parasites and internal parasites. Okay, so the external parasites, first if we talk about the external parasites, like these can be lice, fleas, ticks, etc., they live on, where do they live? These external parasites live on the skin of, they live on the skin of cows and buffaloes, that is outside the body of cows and buffaloes. Okay, and they cause diseases. For example, there is a parasite called buffalo leech, and its scientific name is Hirudinaria okay so Hirudinaria granulosa, this is the scientific name of buffalo leech, and it sucks blood of buffalo. What does it do? It sucks blood of buffalo, and this leads to anemia in buffalo. So this is an external parasite. Then there are also internal parasites. Okay, so internal parasites can be the worms that affecting the stomach and intestine of cattle. Okay, so these parasites are present or they live inside the body of these cattle, that is inside the body of cows and buffaloes. Okay, so we would take one example, that is certain flukes such as fasciola gigantica and another one, that is fasciola hepatica, they cause damage to the liver of the cattle. So what do? They damage the liver. They damage the liver of the cattle. Alright. So this is about the parasitic diseases. Now we will move on and talk about the viral diseases. So viral diseases are those that are caused by the viruses. Alright. So we would take various examples like cowpox. So what are the symptoms of cowpox? Symptoms. So it is a viral disease caused by a virus. It leads to fever and there is appearance of small nodules. Okay. Then the next example would be Rinderpest. What happens in this disease? So let's see the symptoms. If we talk about the symptoms, it leads to constipation. There is severe diarrhea. There is also loss of appetite. Okay. Then there is also discharge from where? Discharge from the nostril and also from the eyes. Okay. After that, we would talk about the foot and mouth disease. Okay. So this is also a viral disease. And the symptoms include there is appearance of blister, and this blister appear in mouth. Okay, so there is appearance of blister in mouth and foot. Also, there is severe soreness and shivering. There is severe soreness and also there is shivering. Okay. Then the next disease is rabies, which is also a viral disease, and the symptoms are restlessness and it also leads to paralysis. Alright. Then the next disease is dermatitis, and what happens in this disease? So there is irritation. Okay, there is irritation, blisters, and there are eruptions. There are eruptions on the skin surface. Okay. So, these are few of the viral diseases that occur in cattle. Next, let's talk about, after viral diseases. Okay, so now after viral diseases, we would be talking about the next category of diseases, that is the bacterial diseases. Okay. So, under bacterial diseases, there is a disease called anthrax. So, what are the symptoms? Symptoms include fever, then there is swelling of body. These are the symptoms. So, there is no requirement of writing symptoms for every disease. So, let's just begin writing the symptoms directly. So, these are the symptoms. There is swelling in the body. There is reduction in milk secretion. Okay. So, these are some of the symptoms of anthrax. Then the next disease is black quarter. So, what happens here? There is fatal kind of toxemia in young cattle. Alright. Then the next bacterial disease is tuberculosis. So, what are the symptoms of tuberculosis? There is fever, lung infection, that is infection in lungs. There is infection. Okay. So, the infection happens in lungs, udders, in intestine, etc. Okay. Then, the next disease is mastitis. So, here what happens? The milk that is secreted, this milk is watery. There is also fever and the udder gets swollen. Okay. Then after this there is salmonellosis. What happens in salmonellosis? There is fever, then blood tends to clot, and also there is diarrhea. Okay. And then there is brucellosis. And brucellosis leads to sterility. Sterility due to infection that occurs in the reproductive organs. All right. Then there is hemorrhagic हेमोरेजिक सेप्टिसीमिया. सो व्हाट हैपेंस इन दिस डिजीज, देयर इज फीवर, देयर इज इंक्रीज्ड रेस्पिरेशन, increased respiration, salivation, and there is also anorexia. Okay, so these are some of the common bacterial diseases that occur in cattle. Next, we would be discussing about the fungal diseases. Okay, so here we would be talking about the fungal diseases. So the most common fungal disease is ringworm. So what are the symptoms of ringworm? They develop small circular and discolored patches. Okay, so this is the most common fungal disease, that is, this disease is caused by fungi. Alright, so now let's quickly revise everything that we have covered today about the cattle farming, and this is the third part of cattle farming. So first we had begun with the feed of cattle. Okay, so talking about the feed of cattle, there are requirement. The feeding requirement in dairy animals can be classified into two types. One is the maintenance requirement and the other is the milk producing requirement. Now, the animal feed can be classified into two types of substances. One is the concentrate and the other is the roughage. So, first we discussed about concentrate. So, it is actually a mixture of substances that are rich in one or more than one nutrients like fats, proteins, carbohydrates, minerals and vitamins. Okay, so it has a low content of fiber but has a high content of protein and other nutrients. So it would also include oil seeds, barley, oats, jowar, gram, bajra, etc. and some of the other byproducts like gram husk, rice bran, etc. Then we also discussed about roughage. So what is this roughage? It largely contains fibers like green fodder, silage, hay, legumes like cowpea, barseem, etc. And a balanced diet is required, or it is essential for all the cattle as well, like it is essential for us, that is, like human beings, cattle also require a balanced diet. So the general content of dairy cattle feed includes green fodder and green grasses, that is the roughage part, which is about 15 to 20 kg. Then it includes grain mixture, which is the concentrates part, and that is about 4 to 5 kg. And then water is also present in the diet, that is around 30 to 35 liters. Okay. And in addition to all these things, there is also additive feed present like antibiotics, hormones, etc. So these help to facilitate the growth of animals, good yield of milk, and they also protect the animals or the cattle from different diseases. Okay. So then we discussed about the diseases of cattle. So first we talked about the parasitic diseases. So parasites are of two types, external parasites and internal parasites. So external parasites can be lice, fleas, ticks, etc., which live on the skin of cows and buffaloes, that is outside their body. For example, the fellow leech, that is Hirudinaria granulosa, it sucks the blood of buffalo and it causes anemia. Then internal parasites are those worms that affect the stomach and intestine of cattle. That is, these parasites live inside the body of animals. For example, flukes like Fasciola giganta and Fasciola hepatica, they damage the liver of cattle. Alright. Then we talked about viral diseases. That is, these diseases are caused by viruses. So cowpox disease, it leads to fever and appearance of small nodules. Okay. Then there is rinderpest, and this leads to constipation, severe diarrhea, loss of appetite, discharge from nostril and eyes. Okay. Then the next disease is foot and mouth disease. It leads to appearance of blisters in mouth and foot and severe soreness and shivering. Then the next disease under viral diseases that we discussed was rabies. It leads to restlessness and paralysis. Then there is a disease called dermatitis that causes irritation, blisters and eruptions on the skin surface. Okay. Then we discussed about the bacterial diseases. The first disease was anthrax. It leads to fever, swelling of body, reduction in milk secretion. Then there is black quarter. It leads to fatal toxemia in young cattle. Then tuberculosis. It causes fever, infection in lungs, udders, intestine, etc. Then there is mastitis. Here what happens is milk becomes watery, there is fever and the udder is swollen. Then there is salmonellosis that causes fever, blood clot and diarrhea. Then there is also brucellosis that leads to sterility due to the infection in reproductive organs. And then there is hemorrhagic septicemia that leads to fever, increased respiration, salivation and anorexia. Alright. Then finally we talked about the fungal diseases, that is the diseases caused by various fungi. So the most important fungal diseases in cattle is the ringworm disease. This leads to small, circular and discolored patches on the cattle. Okay. So I hope you all would have got some great insights by watching today's video. Please do not forget to like and share the video. Till then, thank you for watching.